Hello, I'm Chris Menard. Feel free to subscribe to my channel. I've been doing a lot of Excel pivot tables lately, so I kept thinking, why not one more to start off this week? So here we go. I've got some data here. Let's do it correctly. Make it a table. Control T, hit OK. By the way, another tip, after you make it a table, go and name that table. I'm going to call this dealerships, cars. I don't care. Dealerships works. Now let's make the pivot table. Three cool items I'm going to do here. One, I'm going to just do the totals by column B, the brand, and I'm going to do the totals for the invoice amount, which is column E. So right now, column B and column E in my pivot table. I'm also going to throw in column C, who were the reps for those brands. But then we're going to start dealing with percentages using pivot tables. Cool features. So here we go right now. Insert pivot table. It picks up my table. Hit OK. There I go. I will zoom in just a little bit. My fields are over here. I'm going to check brand and I'm going to check invoice amount as promised. I do want to fix these numbers real quick. It just drives me crazy. There we go. All the numbers are fixed. So I'm going to pull invoice amount in here a second time into the values. And the reason I did that is this, what I'm about to do is a very, very popular feature in pivot tables. If I just right click here and point to show value as, no calculation, show it's showing the sum again. I'm going to say percentage of the grand total. My grand total is 33 million. Click on this. And there are my percentages right there. So if you know what absolute reference is in Excel, the pivot table is taking care of this for me. Now, if I add something else to the rows in the areas, and I'm going to take rep, watch this, drag and drop it. I want to see it below brand. Look at column A. I've got my brands first. It has given me a subtotal up here at the top and then it's given me percentage. So Acura is 8.71% of my grand total. And I'm going to actually copy this and do a quick test. 33 million. Paste the values. Let's see if this is correct. Equals 2922275. I know I could have referenced that cell. There's your 8%. So. And then the 636129 right here, and we're going to do this formula equals B5 divided by E4. That's that grand total. There is where that 1.90% is coming from. So now what I want to know, let me just move this over in case I need it later. I don't think I will. But now what I know, and here's where we're going to get fancy, is because I've got two items here, well, I want to know for Acura, this 2.9 million, what percentage are the rep numbers of that? So I clicked in here again, invoice amount. So now in the values is three different items, the total, the grand total percentages. But what am I going to do in D? I'm going to right click. Show value as, this is going to be percentage of parent row total. Row 4 is a parent row total. Row 10 is a parent row total. 21.77%. Again, I'm just going to do real quick. Equal B5 divided by cell B4. So this time I'm referencing B4, not that grand total. And there's where your 21% is coming from right there. Cool, cool, cool feature. Now, here's something really advanced. I've only got two fields that I'm using over in column A, the rows. What happens if I take the dealership and drag the dealership and put it below the rep? So now I'm sitting here with three fields. I've already got exactly what I want in column B, column C, and in column D. And by the way, you can change these. Grand percentage of GT, grand total, percentage of row total. Well, I've got this ABC dealership and I've got a rep called Art Vandelay. I want to know what percentage the dealerships are of the reps. So to do this one, let's drag invoice amount in again. Right click. I'm going to use show value as. So we keep going to show value as. And I'm going to do percentage of parent total. The parent is Acura, followed by then we've got reps, Art Vandelay. So when I come here, this is why Microsoft Excel is asking me, okay, what percentages do you want to calculate? Do you want to do the dealership? Do you want to do the car brand? Or do you want to do the rep? And in this example, it is going to be the rep. Hit okay. Notice that the 100% is not in cell E4. It is sitting here in cell E5. And there is 59.1. Those three equal 100%. Basically what it's saying is 375,000 divided by 636,000 is 59.10%. Cool, cool feature right there. And I will rename this one. Real quick review. Again, feel free to subscribe if you're happy. What I used in column E is percentage of parent total, and I picked the rep. Column D is percentage of parent row total. And then this was the percentage of the grand total. So how about that? That is why I love pivot tables. Feel free to subscribe again, ring the bell, and of course, I hope you have a wonderful week. Thank you.